The man who survived a pit bull attack.
Sadly, his wheelchair-bound mother was killed.
It happened on my watch. You know, it was something I brought into the house.
Overwhelmed by grief and guilt, Joe Varnese is still struggling to figure out why the dog he adopted 3 weeks ago suddenly snapped.
We were just trying to go to the bathroom, and he just went berserk. I flipped the dog over, slammed him on the ground. That didn't help. He came back stronger. All right. I hit him with the leg of the wheelchair. He didn't even faze him. I tried. I fell down on the floor. I tried, but I did get up, and that's when I started beating the dog, and to no avail. No avail.
No signs of aggression before that?
Never. Never. No signs of aggression.
Joe tells me that it will be hard for him to trust another animal, especially a pit bull breed, after all of this.
Tragic death in San Bernardino County tonight involving a pit bull. 5-year-old boy is dead after being attacked by the family dog.
Yes, Colleen. In fact, we've been in touch with two relatives, one in person and one by phone. And they both tell us the parents of the boy were at work when the attack happened, and everyone is at a loss to explain why the dog snapped.
The 5-year-old boy whom San Bernardino sheriffs say was killed by his family's pit bull, a cousin who asked we not show her face, says she and the boy's uncle were here babysitting when, without warning, the pet mauled the child, who was briefly left alone in a playroom out back.
I jumped in to try to help, and it was too late.
First responders rushed over, but the boy died on scene. We're told his parents are distraught and in seclusion with other relatives. Cousin says the family got the pit bull when he was a puppy. She knows other animal lovers praise the breed, but for this family, they'll never have another.
Don't trust them. Don't trust pit bulls, because they could change at any moment and not even know it.
I don't know what to make of it, but I know that was it on purpose.
Heaven Estacio mourning the loss of her mom, Melissa, tonight. The 44-year-old mauled to death in her Somerset home Friday night, killed by her 8-year-old pit bull, Amigo. The DA says the dog attacked the victim while she was having a seizure, but her family says Melissa had epilepsy for decades and the dog since it was a puppy. They believe it was just trying to help.
What happened that night? It never happened like that before.
The incident is the second of its kind in Bristol County this year. A dog also killed a teenage boy in Dighton back in May, with town selectmen voting to euthanize it. The fate of Amigo, however, remains unclear, as the family of his owner mourns what they say was just an accident.
All my mom ever wanted was for me and her 3 kids was to have a better life than she could. And I just want to say I love you, Mom.
A recently adopted pit bull terrier went on a rampage, biting 4 people. And now that dog is scheduled to be put down tomorrow.
We went to go and play with him, and something in him just switched. Like, I don't know what it was, but it just switched. And he went after my dad. He jumped on top of my dad and went after him. And I jumped on top of the dog. And I was trying to pull my dad's skin from under him.
Then the dog turned on her.
6-year-old Camden Bozell rode to the ambulance by himself due to COVID-19 after that dog attack that happened in Schoolcraft. But this little boy certainly has a long road ahead to recovery.
A smiley 6-year-old here, Camden Bozell, is showing off a missing tooth. And again, for school picture day.
Literally, like, within a second, the dog went for his face.
This is Cam now. His face is covered in stitches and has a broken nose and a fractured skull after he was attacked by a dog.
I really didn't know until after he came out of surgery.
Oh my
God. And I seen his face and I was horrified.
Cam's mom says she was at work when he was attacked by the dog while at his grandma's house.
Completely unprovoked. This dog has no history of aggression. He's used to being around loud, rambunctious kids.
The dog is a pit bull, but Cam's mom says she doesn't blame the breed.
And I love pit bulls too. I always have. Now when people are asking, you know, what breed he was, and I just don't want to answer them because I know that once I say it's a pit bull, I don't know, I guess I would just say to not trust your animals.
And without a doubt, there's a long road ahead for this little boy toward healing.
This dog is described as a family member. It's 5 years old, raised as a puppy, and tonight it may have attacked the one person who loved it most.
My pit bull attacked my wife for no reason.
Family and friends told Weeks to get rid of the dog. Now he wishes he'd listened.
And anybody got any pit bull to get rid of them, because I never thought it would attack my wife.
That is something that a West Wego man thought he'd never have to say until Wednesday. That's when three of his pit bulls brutally attacked his wife inside of their home, severely injuring the woman and forcing police to shoot the dog.
She responds to you now when you talk to her. She can't see you, but she'll shake her head. Yes or no.
Clarence Allen talking about his wife, Linda Henry, who suffered severe injuries Wednesday when police say three of the family's four adult pit bulls attacked her inside the couple's Avenue A home.
We treated these dogs like children. They never had a fight. They ate out the same bowls. I don't know what happened.
That's right, Laura. Family members out here tonight telling responding deputies that they were forced to keep Buster locked away, separated from the family's other two dogs because he was a threat. Well, tonight, one family member stabbed the pit bull to death right here in their front yard after a vicious attack.
He was the sweetest dog ever.
Family members can't believe Buster turned violent.
I would have never in a million years thought that this would happen.
We've learned tonight the dog repeatedly bit Heidi Cooper and her 14-year-old daughter. Deputies calling this a vicious attack, stopped only after another daughter stabbed Buster several times until he died.
Devastated. They were literally devastated. Like, I know it's heartbreaking for them too, because they would never want that to happen.
Pitbull attacks his new owner in North Idaho just 24 hours after the man adopted the dog from Kootenai Humane Society. The man should be okay, but he lost nearly 2 pints of blood.
Well, the attack happened inside this house. The man who lives here says he went to wake his daughter up this morning. When he opened her bedroom door, he says that's when the pit bull attacked him. Hai Dang showed us where the dog bit his hand, leg, and cut his head. Deputies say Dang was arguing with his 16-year-old daughter through her bedroom door. They say the raised voices caused the dog to become upset, and Dang says he was attacked in the living room. He says he tried to push the dog off of him, and his daughter even tried to restrain the dog, but he says it's very strong, and it wasn't even the first time he has been bit.
I love him too, but he attacked me. It's the third time. I don't want him coming back to my house.
A grandmother has been mauled, her face is scarred as you saw, and her mangled arms are wrapped in bandages.
And her attackers weren't strangers. They were the dogs that live in her own home.
Battered, bruised, and hospitalized, a woman talks about the pit bull attack she survived.
I had a dog who had a pit bull wrapped around my neck.
Virginia Beach is considering legal action after an elderly woman died a horrific death. The dog they adopted yesterday mauled their grandmother that same night.
The woman was in her 90s. She died this morning at a hospital.
The woman across the street in her 90s was attacked by a dog her family just adopted that day. Her granddaughter, Amber Patterson, says the one-year-old pit bull terrier pushed her grandmother to the ground and brutally attacked her for about 5 minutes. She says it happened after they took the dog's shock collar off that he wore home from the adoption center.
To know that she just adopted a dog and it turned out to be this vicious to her, that was very shocking.
Forever Home Rehabilitation Center, where they got the dog, said in a statement they are devastated over what happened, and that the dog, Blue, passed his evaluations with flying colors before being adopted out to the Patterson family.
Two people are recovering after an attack inside their car while driving down the road.
The woman and her son were traveling with two small dogs and their pit bull inside this truck.
Ran up her to them.
But June Lisby couldn't figure out what all the commotion was about.
And what did you see when you got up to the vehicle?
A lot of steamed up windows, couldn't tell what was going on.
Just then, the woman's son was able to get out. That's when June realized the two were being attacked by their own pit bull inside their white pickup truck while driving down the road.
I knocked on the window and got the dog come after me, and then the young lady got out.
And her whole shirt was just like covered in blood. Her arm was just like, you couldn't even see the bone. The bone was gone. It was completely gone.
Gut-wrenching to listen to. About 7 minutes worth of calls to 911 and rescue. Calls coming from two sons who are literally helpless. You hear it in their voices. Kept back by what sounds like two vicious dogs hovering over their mother. Now, it started with a call from the woman's 21-year-old son who found his mother lying in the yard covered with blood. At this point in the tape, He has no idea that the dogs were the ones who did it.
What are you putting in emergency?
I need an ambulance. My mom's on the phone. She got blood everywhere. She's laying on the ground.
Where are you? How did she get hurt?
I don't know. I just got out of the shower and I went out there to see if she got a trash can. And she was just laid out there. I don't know what happened.
Now, that 21-year-old has no clue that his mother is very likely dying steps from her home. It isn't really until he tries to get closer to her that he realizes what has done this to her.
How long ago till you saw her? Where is she bleeding from?
The girl bang shackles. I know she's got a cut on her eye and her shirt's all bloody, so I don't know if she's still.
Okay, how old is she?
40-something.
Is she breathing?
Breathing.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Is she breathing?
It's a drill away from her. She's got a pole.
Is she breathing?
I don't feel her breathing. God, get away from her. No.
Are you there?
I think she got disconnected.
Was she yelling at the dogs?
Yeah. They're on the way.
I just... so upsetting. You know, it sounds like that 21-year-old tried to reach for his mother, as you heard him say, Tina Marie Canterbury, desperately in need of medical attention. But, you know, as her son tried to get close to her, you heard all that sound. Those were the dogs barking at him. And we're told that the dogs actually turned on him, biting his throat. Now you're going to hear his brother call 911.
Where's your animals at?
They're in the backyard. They're over my mom. They won't let us get near.
Okay, so they're by your mom and you guys can't get to your mother?
Yes. As my brother Chuck got there and checked her pulse, I think, and they attacked him too.
Call animal control and tell me on 246 that the brothers won't let us get to a victim.
Now, something else about that call. The son obviously wanted help immediately for his mother.
Police in Virginia say a woman was mauled to death by her two pit bulls while taking them for a walk.
He says the dog used to come over to their house and play with their kids in a friendly, harmless way. He doesn't know what changed Russ. He doesn't know what provoked this attack. But this afternoon, the little girl is still in the hospital. She'll have stitches in her head and a scar that goes all the way from her hairline down to her temple. This dog, named Milo, attacked a 9-year-old girl. The official report says the pit bull burrowed under a fence from the yard next door to where the victim was playing.
A 3-year-old pit bull named Midnight.
Well, she's nice.
But around 4:30 in the afternoon, Midnight attacked the little boy, biting him, police say, in the face and neck.
They were all just sitting in the living room, just playing, and the dog just went after the 2-year-old.
Rescue crews had to fly the boy by helicopter to Johns Hopkins.
It's shocking me right now.
Investigators say the family owned the dog since it was a puppy, and there have been no previous incidents where it attacked anyone.
I think that's what dogs do sometimes.
That's what's really kind of shocking, is to think that Midnight, no, she don't, never.
I wish I would have been here, you know. I wish, you know, if we could all go back, you know, I wish, you know, that I would have took them with me, something, you know.
Juan Ortiz is the owner of the pit bulls. We have pictures of the pit bulls for you to see them. Now, the victim in all this, the 84-year-old woman, is in the hospital in critical condition. We're told she was simply walking outside around her neighborhood when she was violently mauled by the pit bulls. The owner tells me he knows pit bulls have a violent reputation, but he's still surprised something like this involving his dogs has now happened.
My dogs were not for fighting. They were family dogs. They're indoor dogs. I have a 2-year-old daughter, 5-year-old son, 6-year-old son, and a 13-year-old son that play with them. They've been with them since they were puppies, you know, so it really kind of blew my mind what happened.
Tonight, police in Pennsylvania say a pit bull that was adopted from Baltimore mauled a woman and two of her children.
Animal control officers take a pit bull into their custody after police say it attacked its owner inside this home on George Street in Dayton.
It's my fault. I shouldn't have been yelling at her. We was fighting over the kid, and she just, dog just went crazy.
Keisha Stroud is the victim's sister. She was home when the attack happened, along with their mother and the victim's 3-year-old daughter. Stroud says she was arguing with her sister when the dog suddenly attacked her.
Ralph Hughes raised these 3 pit bulls since they were puppies.
I ain't never had no problem with them yet. I love my beavers. But...
that all changed Monday morning when all 3 dogs attacked an elderly woman.
I can't believe it, because they're so good with people, you know. You think you know them, but you don't, you know.
The victim was walking off Spring Lake Highway, a route she usually walks, when 3 pit bulls attacked her. When animal control was called to the scene, at least one of the dogs attempted to attack the officers. Beanbag rounds were used to subdue them. Hughes gave the approval for the dogs to be put down.
Man, that was the first thing, man, you know. I wouldn't have no other way, you know. I'm so sorry. If I could change, I would, you know. But I'm just sorry.